Welcome to the Soccer Academy. I'm Antonio Suave, your host, and we're here in northern Italy in the beautiful mountain village of San Antonio Tortale. And we're with the soccer team of Serie D in Italy, AC Belluno. And they're here in this village training and getting ready for the season. So stay tuned, because when we come back, we're going to bring you more of AC Belluno, its coaches' training methods, and some food as well.
Alla correre indietro.
We're here on the Via Roma, which means Roma Street, of course named after the capital city of Rome. And just down this beautiful little street is a tiny little church, and they say it's something really cool to see. So let's go take a look. The city of Melle is located in the province of Belluno in the northeastern region of Italy, known as the Veneto region. The main square, also known as a piazza in Italian, was recently named after the late Pope Luciani. So it is now referred to as Luciani Square. The square contains many archaeological treasures, such as the Casa Fulcis, which means the house of the family of Fulcis, as well as the beautiful and ancient church, the Chiesa della Dolorata. It is believed that the church dates back nearly 1300 years to the year 700 AD. The city of Melle is also known for its beautiful landscapes and cultural activities. It is situated about 110 miles north of Venice and has a population of nearly 8,000 people. It is literally pressed up against the famous river Piave and is at the foot of the magnificent Dolomite Mountains. In Italian, these mountains are known as I Dolomiti. Prior to the unification of Italy in the late 1800s, the city was dominated for many years by the city-state known as the Republic of Venice, or La Repubblica di Venezia.
We're back here with Gino Maldera, one of the greatest players of all time here in Italy. He played with AC Milan and Catanzaro, and he's going to be with us to demonstrate inside of the foot and outside of the foot stopping. So the first thing we're going to show the kids at home, we're going to go over this one more time with you that are a professional soccer player, is we're going to throw the ball up, take it down, take a few steps, inside of the right, inside of the left, and then we're going to come back and do outside of the right and outside of the left.
Sono io, quello di qui la festa, quello con il cappellino, quello senza la testa, dovevate farmi fuori sei anni fa. Se volevate la tranquillità, e invece sono qui, vive ancora parlante. Questo è il nostro quinto album, non sono un cantante, faccio il rap. Quella musica dura, quella senza melodia, quella che fa paura, paura. Ma dove andremo a finire? Ma guarda un po' cosa ci tocca sentire. Intanto mentre sto parlando il rap è stato in Italia, questo genere del quale io mi sento una balia, senza false modestie. Questo LP esce in un momento dove finalmente anche qui il rap ha assunto dimensioni, oltre alla curiosità, e coinvolge gente di tutte le età. Ah yeah! Finalmente si muove, finalmente una ventata di compagini nuove. Il ragazzo con un giradischio è un campionatore, un cervello per pensare organizza il rumore e ci dice sopra tempo tutto quello che pensa. Musica incazzata contro la violenza. Rap. Rap.
You just saw it done by a great professional, Gino Maldera, formerly with AC Milan and Catanzaro of the Italian Serie A. Gino, thank you very much.
Teo viene in mezzo a giocare Teo. Cerca la volata Teo, servito Brian Diaz, Leao, gol! Ha segnato Rafa e Leao, vedo una punizione granata.
questo giro tondo d'anime.
There is a great soccer camp in northern Italy called the AC Milan Junior Camp. The camp operates in some of the most beautiful areas of Italy and Croatia, including in this fantastic ski village known as Cortina d'Ampezzo. And by the way, Cortina is host to the next Winter Olympics. Ma più mi guardo in giro e vedo che c'è un mondo che va avanti anche se tu non ci sei più. This is one of the most difficult skills to learn in soccer, the bicycle kick. You have to be really careful when practicing it, and make sure that you have a well-padded surface to land on. This shot was made famous by the great Brazilian soccer player, Pelé. E dopo poco tempo ci siamo anche frequentati, parlando sottovoce durante una lezione. Ci siamo messi a scrivere una strana canzone. Le rime cadevano dalla mente sopra un foglio. L'ora passava e riuscivo sempre meglio. Now, let's see some volley shots. The AC Milan Junior Camps have some of the greatest soccer coaches around, including former superstars such as Pirino Prati and Gino Maldera. Not to mention the AC Milan youth scout, Otello Di Remigio. Otello personally trains each and every player at the youth camps.
Domani sera lo vediamo. Com'è andata?
Bene.
Brahim Diaz, splendido il suo assist a Rafa Leao, se ne va Brahimino. Ma l'ha sgambettato! L'ha sgambettato! Rigore. Gol! KK che sì! 2-0 per noi! 2-0 per noi! 2-0 per noi! KK che sì! Ora Belotti in buca, Kjaer, gigantesco Kjaer su Verdi.
Abbiamo visto bandiere, aquiloni, astronavi, abbiamo visto le foto bianco e nero, l'Italia che vince i mondiali. Abbiamo visto le piazze e noi bambini invecchiare. Abbiamo visto le stelle da un marciapiede.
Here we are in the city of Mel, and we're just outside of a hotel where the AC Belluno soccer team
comes to eat every day for lunch and dinner. They also sleep here in a family-owned hotel. This area, known as Mel, is just on the outskirts of the city of Belluno. And behind me are the foothills of the Dolomite Mountains. They're called the Pedemontane.
The mountain village of San Antonio Tortal sits above the Val Belluna region and is located just above the cities of Mel and Belluno. It's a steep climb to the top, and you should probably use a car to head up to the village. But, believe it or not, some serious cyclists actually make that climb on their bicycles. Yep, that would be a lot of pedaling for sure.
Now we're at the beginning of the process. This is where the kids get up in the morning and they get ready for practice. And I'm here at Al Moro Albergo Ristorante, which is a restaurant and hotel, and it's owned by Roberta and her family members. So they allow the kids to eat here, they let them sleep here, and then they also make a little bit of noise, but they get prepped for the day of work.
In Italy, most teams begin preseason training camp in mid to late July. Each team usually spends between 2 and 3 weeks together in a mountain village where they train together and eat together every day. In Italian, this is called ritiro. The players use this time to bond as a team and to prepare for the physical challenges of the long season ahead.
We just got done eating lunch with the AC Belluno soccer team, and I'm here with one of the assistant coaches, Alessandro Prest. And we're going to drink some coffee, and they tell me this is some of the best coffee in the world. It even gives Starbucks a run for its money. So let's check it out. I think it's time to drink this coffee. Cheers. That's good coffee.
La società comunque ha deciso di ripartire con grande entusiasmo per cercare di ottenere un obiettivo importante, quindi di essere tra le protagoniste di questo campionato.
If you can believe it, the team of Belluno Calcio was actually founded in 1905. That's right. For most of its history, the team has played in the Italian 3rd and 4th division. In Italian, these divisions are known as the Serie C and the Serie D. Italy has 3 primary divisions of professional soccer, and those divisions are known as the Serie A, which is the first division and is also the Premier League in Italy. Then comes the Serie B, the second division. After that is the Serie C, the third division. Below the professional divisions is the Italian semi-professional division, known as Serie D. This is the division in which AC Belluno plays, and its players are officially considered as semi-pros.
Arriva in una società importante per questa categoria perché il Belluno fa provincia, c'è uno stadio buono e c'è molta organizzazione.
Devo parlare, devo iniziare con un boom nella testa, posso iniziare a breccare, partendo freestyle, mi butto in pista ed è una fissa, mentre vedo Gaspar che suoni smista e poi mi fissa. Perché mi fermo all'improvviso in freeze. Pronto no? Come Fugees. Mi sento come John, travolta in Grease. Muscio trendy, facendo un po' di twist, twist.
Guarda come dondolo, come Don Lurio. Questa caspa base ora mi studio, per trovare i passi per far muovere il mio culo. Seguo il giusto tempo, perché sono duro. Strong, le rime le dispongo nella song, con la ZA che mi fiamma il corazon. Si sente mai nell'aria.
Il Belluno Calcio crede molto nell'attività di destrezza, di agilità, di ritmo, e la inserisce sempre nei riscaldamenti, quotidianamente o quasi ogni giorno.
Campers at the AC Milan Junior Camp are treated just like first division pros. They travel on a huge motor coach to and from the practice field every day. And they have official uniforms and warm-up suits provided by the AC Milan organization. Don't forget the basics. As boring as it may seem, the basics are essential, to say the least. Stretching is also a fundamental part of the game. Hard work is certainly the key to becoming a better soccer player. Target shooting is great practice for free kicks and restarts too. Even I had a chance to train with the campers a bit. Foosball, or table soccer, is popular just about everywhere in the world. The Italians call it biliardino, or calcio balilla, depending on where you're at in Italy. Castelbrando is one of the oldest castle structures in all of Europe. It has over 2,000 years of history and is located in a place called Cison di Valmarino. The castle is so big that it has a museum on site, as well as a hotel, two restaurants, and its very own ice cream shop. You've gotta love that Italian gelato. Mmm, che buono!
Giro intorno a te, che sei il mio sole anche di notte. Tu non ti stanchi mai, non ti fermi mai, con gli occhi neri e quelle labbra disegnate come un girasole. Giro intorno a te, che sei il mio sole anche di notte.
Thanks for joining us here on the Soccer Academy. And remember, if you want to know more about the Soccer Academy, just log on to www.socceracademy.tv. That's www.socceracademy.tv. Because for us, soccer is always a kick in the grass. God bless you. We'll see you again soon on another episode of the Soccer Academy.